I love Legos. The chaos of all those little pieces, following my instruction book, and this organized, structured thing emerges. I've been collecting Lego for, I don't even want to say how many years now, maybe 40 years. I don't honestly know how many I have. You know, I have these old notebooks from when I was a kid listing all the parts in my sets and naming them all. In those days, I used to love to put them together, take them apart, put them together, take them apart, put them together. I would memorize how to put them all together. And I also was obsessed with cataloging what was in each set. Yeah, so that's kind of like a scientist, right? Like I was a junior scientist for sure. I first came across sea urchins as an undergrad in a developmental biology class. And I liked what I saw because they're so simple. It's simple to understand what happens to them as a developing embryo. But I never ever imagined that I would actually be doing sea urchin research. Okay, so I'm really excited about your experiment today. Yeah, it's gonna be awesome. Okay, let's see what we can get in here. Okay, maybe that pink one is a good choice. It looks like a girl to me. Let's give it a try. Okay, so let's start with this one and see what we can do. I'm interested in how patterns form during embryonic development. Like if you think about that every one of us started out life as one single cell, how does that cell give rise to our complicated three-dimensional patterned body? Sea urchins have not got very many cells in the embryo as they develop. You know, they're morphologically simple. They're also transparent so we can see through them. The mechanisms that propel development are highly conserved in evolution. And so what we learn from a simple animal, we can extend to a more complicated animal like vertebrates and mammals and humans. That first 48 hours is what most of our experiments are focused on. Everything goes from being one single cell to, you know, a pretty complicated, patterned, full-on animal in the course of 2 days. How does that happen? What's the instruction book to build an animal, right? That instruction book, how is that encoded? Is it encoded the way a Lego set would be encoded? My interest in science and in embryonic development and my interest in Lego come from the same place. I've always been fascinated by how things go together. How do you build an engine? How do you build an embryo? How do you build a house? With the Legos, you start with the instruction book and you build the thing. Here I'm starting with the built thing and I want to figure out what's the instruction book. How does it work? How do you design it? You know, how do you make it? How do you make it? Yeah.